Hey everyone, this is Soren, and I promise I won't talk as long this time as I did last time after the Breath of the Wild Switch trailer video. So first of all, I want to apologize for the delay. You know, this trailer came out from like a month and a half ago at this point, and I would have had this out sooner, but I moved to a different city in the US, and that was sort of, I had an almost completed version of this before I moved, but then the move got in the way, I started a new job. And, you know, finally getting done with it right now, so I apologize for that. As far as the process of making these arrangements in Ocarina of Time, it's kind of funny, not too much has changed since 2017, though a lot of the tool chains and stuff have gotten more advanced. We're using sort of different tools, but the basic idea of just setting up something in a DAW and transcribing the music is basically the same. Now, I am actually using the Triforce Percent toolchain that I and other folks from the Triforce Percent team created in order to test the music in-game. So this is, you know, this video was captured on a real N64, and it was actually captured from a ROM that was almost completely unmodified. All of the music data and everything was injected using the Triforce Percent toolchain. The reason for that being, first of all, it's the toolchain that I'm much more comfortable with compared to something like the decomp. But also, it allows you to do like refinement, you know, change something and then re-inject that and listen to the new version without having to actually shut down the game. So even if you're just running this in an emulator, you can't do live patching with emulators, but you can do that with the arbitrary code execution. This is the largest bank that I have ever made for a song, and possibly the largest bank that anyone has made for any game using the N64, you know, the first party Nintendo sound engine here. There's 28 instruments, plus one instrument, which is not a audio bank instrument, but a waveform. I'll talk about that in a moment. Plus a number of percussion instruments. So really a huge bank, and I was actually expecting that the bank and the sequence both would not fit into memory without doing, you know, making some changes to the way memory is allocated. But the bank just fit just fine, despite being so huge. And then the sequence ended up being just under, the first draft of it ended up being just under the maximum sequence size, which is hex 3800 bytes. And then as I worked on it, it became a little larger, but I was able to, you know, reduce some, you know, copy and paste some CC curves and stuff like that and make it actually fit. So there wasn't any changes to the audio engine needed in order to make this, you know, huge piece in Ocarina of Time. There are three custom samples used. I'm still counting this as within the Ocarina of Time engine despite that, because two of those samples are strings and piano, the sample from Ocarina of Time that's been pitched up by an octave, because the RSP can't actually pitch up an instrument sound more than two octaves above its bass sound. So if you want it higher than that, you have to pitch it up in advance. So that's what I did for those two samples. And the third one is the hard saxophone sample from Majora's Mask. So it's still, you know, it's Majora's Mask engine, I guess, instead of it's in the Ocarina of Time engine, but that's a sample from Majora's Mask. All of the other samples are from Ocarina of Time. So I mentioned this waveform. The games that use this sound format, so Mario 64, Ocarina of Time, and the others, have a chiptune engine in their sound engine. They can not only play sampled, audio bank samples of instrument sounds that are from recordings, but they can also synthesize certain waveforms, like square and saw, and the kind of the basic stuff that you would get on a NES or whatever. So in Ocarina of Time, if you unlock a door or something, you get the Zelda chime, do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. That is not actually an instrument sound that is being played through this chiptune synthesis engine. And so that's actually used for a couple of notes in this piece. At the very end, there's a saw wave that you know, descends and then has a low note. And that's actually playing on that engine. So that's why I said 28 instruments plus one. The plus one is not an instrument, but it's one of these waveforms. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another 6 years for the big trailer for the next Zelda game on whatever the Switch successor will be.